Hello, this is Edmund Mejero with Autodesk. I'll be presenting how Autodesk InfraWorks can help you understand demands, train frequencies, and social spacing on stations under new security guidelines. Frequently, train stations are overcrowded at peak hours. New security guidelines mandate a 6-foot spacing between passengers. Social distance must then be maintained throughout the station walkways, platforms, in train carriages. Likewise, train stations must be partially closed to avoid two-way traffic and to provide proper maintenance. Social distancing must always be provided at entrance and exit queues. Microsimulation optimizes train frequencies, station conditions as carriages are modified, passengers staggering times, social distancing, and balancing cost and benefit of each proposal. I'll be using a 3D train station model created in Revit as a basis for the project. Once I open an InfraWorks model and go into the train station site, I define an area of interest and call out mobility simulation. InfraWorks mobility opens where the Revit model is imported. We'll first explain flows and behaviors under existing conditions. Peak time flow at this intermediate station ranges from 8:55 to 9:15 a.m., served by trains arriving every 5 minutes starting at 9 a.m. Train carriage dimensions and capacities are defined. Flow demands are also defined from all access gates to departure platforms. Flow is also defined from station to station, representing through and exit passengers. Unique colors are assigned to groups and distributed throughout the train. Queues at entrance and exit stands represent incoming flows. Dynamic visual information at stands is available, representing incoming passenger flow as well as train schedules and queuing passengers at platforms. Multiple reports can be generated in Excel format at any interval, where individual reports can also be reviewed, as well as train statistics upon arrival, including schedules, passengers, and capacities. Finally, service reports are also available, which include number of passengers boarding, leaving, and continuing trips. We'll now be analyzing our first proposal under new security guidelines maintaining original demands, original train frequencies, and reduced carriages to 40% capacity. Upon reviewing outgoing stands, users can easily understand that trains run at full capacity at all times and departure platforms also overflow. We now modify the network, proposing original passenger flow, increase train frequency, and reduce carriage capacity. Trains now run every 3 minutes. Simulations run, and by reviewing stands, we can infer that platform capacity is well above current demand, flow is constant, and level of service is maintained. If additional trains can be provided, we must then create a new proposal based on reduced passenger demand, maintain original train frequencies, and reduce train capacity. Demand is reduced to 40% of original values, and by running simulation, we can verify that the solution works very well as capacity is greater than demand, flow remains constant, and desired levels of service are provided. After selecting any adequate proposal, we must now analyze and verify constant social spacing, provide one-way traffic, and adjust boarding times. As internal traffic between platforms is closed, higher volumes on proper gates will now be expected. Passengers must now be given extra time to reach departure platforms before the first scheduled arrival. As simulations run with these adjusted parameters, all capacities are verified and satisfied. In order to hold higher volumes, a new proper queue at entrance must be designed to account for constant social spacing and desired levels of service. By now, properly designing the complete network, platforms are cleared for all demands as the last train arrives. Thank you for watching.